When was the last time a metro line was designed for how people actually live and work today, not 50 years ago? Cities have changed radically, but transit maps remain stuck in the past, relying on hub and spoke systems built for commutes to downtown offices. To finally upgrade its outdated network, Australia is embarking on a massively ambitious mega railway project for Melbourne. At a jaw-dropping cost of $125 billion, it aims to completely reimagine public transportation in one of the world's most livable cities. Stay tuned as we explore this visionary initiative and how it could provide a model for metro systems globally. Metro systems built decades ago are totally outdated for today's cities. They were designed to shuttle suburban riders into downtown office districts. But with mixed-use neighborhoods now the norm, those old transit maps are useless. Melbourne's metro is a prime example, created for a suburb to city commutes. It results in absurdly inefficient rides as offices and homes spread across the metropolis. Census data shows just 3% of residents take the train to work versus 50% who drive, proving the system fails current needs. Faced with outdated infrastructure, leading cities worldwide are urgently upgrading metro systems. London, Tokyo, and NYC are models, showing interconnected routes with frequent service are essential for modern transit. Multiple lines in London intersect, enabling easy transfers and direct A to B journeys. Don't miss out, hit subscribe to TechBlazer. Tokyo's vast metro serves over 8 million riders daily with minimal delays through an integrated maze of crisscrossing lines. NYC's express and local trains intertwine for maximum coverage. The key difference from the old point A to point B designs is versatility. Diverse routes allow efficient travel between any points across metropolises, not just suburbs to downtowns. Forward-looking cities realize bolting new lines onto old single-purpose hubs fails to solve mobility needs. To confront its outdated metro woes, Melbourne has embarked on the Suburban Rail Loop, a monumental mega railway project. With an estimated cost of $125 billion Australian dollars, it will entail constructing a 90 kilometers ring rail line around the city's outer suburbs. This massive undertaking aims to completely reshape Melbourne's public transit for the next century. Planners have divided construction into four phases spanning many decades. The first phase covers 26 kilometers of twin tunnels and six new stations at an estimated $33 billion price tag. It will be completed by 2035, with additional phases stretching into the 2050s. When finished, the Suburban Rail Loop promises high-capacity train lines connecting suburbs to other suburbs, no longer just funneling commuters downtown. This orbital link is envisioned to boost connectivity and access to jobs, education, services, and entertainment across the metropolis. However, delivering on these lofty goals remains highly complex and ambitious. The project is currently short one-third of its proposed funding, leaving a $40-plus billion financing gap. Critics also contend there are cheaper, faster options to upgrade Melbourne's network versus a decades-long megaproject. Additionally, public opinion is divided. Supporters back the initiative as a long-overdue shakeup that can reinvent mobility in Melbourne for the next 100 years. But detractors argue suburban rail links are an outdated concept that falls short of integrating emerging technologies like autonomous vehicles. While the massive scale entails substantial risks, proponents note great cities require great vision. Transforming any major metro system is an ultra-marathon, not a sprint. With population growth expected to increase demand, Melbourne is aiming to get ahead of the curve and build a more accessible, equitable, and sustainable transportation future. While the Suburban Rail Loop takes a long-term view, Melbourne has more immediate concerns to address as well. A key priority is relieving the severe congestion plaguing the central city metro lines during peak periods. This bottleneck cripples the entire system's efficiency. To tackle this problem, Melbourne is building the Metro Tunnel, a new underground metro line running through the heart of the city. By adding cross-city capacity, this project will allow more frequent train service without downtown gridlock. However, the Metro Tunnel initially faced public criticism over its impact on Melbourne's main Swanston Street, a bustling thoroughfare, an iconic part of the city landscape. Original plans called for closing major portions of Swanston Street for several years to enable tunnel and station construction. In response, engineers devised innovative solutions to keep the tunnel alignment unchanged while avoiding major disruption at the surface. Key buildings along the route were carefully demolished and excavations passed beneath Swanston Street itself. This creative approach allowed the metro build-out to proceed with minimal effect on lively areas above ground. Overall, the metro tunnel is part of a coordinated effort to enhance Melbourne's metro, not just for tomorrow, but also today. Untangling downtown bottlenecks delivers immediate improvements in frequency, congestion, and journey times. Meanwhile, larger projects like the suburban rail loop reshape mobility in the long run. Melbourne is taking transportation into the 21st century. Help this channel keep bringing you their inspiring metro revolution story by liking and subscribing. The mega metro expansions in Melbourne have been made possible largely thanks to high-tech tunnel boring machines, or TBMs. These behemoths function like underground drill heads, carving tunnels through earth and rock. Four custom-built TBMs were deployed for Melbourne's metro tunnel project. Each one is a 17-meter-long engineering marvel, tipping the scales at over 1,100 tons. That's roughly equivalent to the Eiffel Tower lying on its side. At the business end, circular cutter heads measuring 100 tons spin and grind through terrain. Powerful cutting edges made from specialized steel can pulverize rock up to 6 times harder than concrete. The TBMs even have their own names reflecting prominent women in Melbourne's history, like former Australian Prime Minister Julia Gillard. Onboard systems provide continuous monitoring with lasers guiding the path. This enables them to bore for kilometers with remarkable precision and control. Crews also work inside the machines during drilling, enabling round-the-clock operations. With kitchens, bathrooms, and workspaces inside, each 4-story-long TBM is like a subway in a subway. These technical marvels have proven indispensable for large-scale metro expansions worldwide. TBMs overcome the logistical headaches of traditional tunneling methods. They allow major underground rail builds to proceed with improved speed, safety, efficiency, and minimal disruption at the surface. Rather than one-off projects, Melbourne's mega metro efforts represent crucial steps toward a unified public transit vision. The city plans additional expansions, integration of autonomous vehicles, more trams, and eco-buses. Together, these will transform Melbourne's network into an interconnected, multimodal mobility ecosystem. This positions the city to meet transport needs of its growing population for decades ahead. An efficient, future-proof metro system provides immense economic and environmental upside. It can boost business, enhance livability, and reduce carbon emissions. For a city of Melbourne's stature, nothing less than world-class, forward-looking transportation will suffice. We're making great headway on this journey through Melbourne's metro revolution, but many of the most pivotal transformations are still ahead. Show your support for telling Melbourne's visionary mobility story by hitting that like button and subscribing to join for the next captivating chapter. Melbourne's metro evolution faces ongoing challenges and criticisms. Funding gaps for the suburban rail loop linger, while opponents argue other transit options could be quicker and cheaper. Some question whether suburban rail is forward-thinking given new technologies on the horizon. Executing a decades-long mobilization of this scale is undoubtedly risky. But proponents say if Melbourne wants to maintain its most livable city title, ambitious action is imperative. These initiatives represent a watershed moment for public transportation in Melbourne. The shift from outdated point-to-point commuter rail to an interconnected, responsive network is fundamental. It positions Melbourne at the forefront of building next-gen metro systems tailored for evolving mixed-use cities. The project also holds lessons for metro systems in need of modernization worldwide. Melbourne is proving even geography-altering overhauls are possible with enough vision and commitment. In an urbanizing world, the time is now for other cities to reimagine mobility.